When I think about books, I touch my shelf. For the recent years, as the living standards get higher and higher, everyone is looking for a way to save a coin. And if they can find a cheaper or more convenient way of doing it, they go for it. Residents of Lucky Summer have confirmed that the Pallets furniture business is giving, not only to those doing the business, but also to the consumers. We have seen everyone use and talk of the normal wood furniture, but ever since the introduction of the Pallets furniture, nothing has been the same. If you ask around, anyone will tell you a pallet is a flat structure used as a base for the unitization of goods in the supply chain. Furniture made out of pallets is, however, a different, unique, and interesting touch to anyone introduced to it. Brian Irungu, a 31-year-old actor, painter, books illustrator, set designer, and entrepreneur, talks us through his journey in the pallets furniture business.
My name is Brian Irungu. I am an actor, painter, set designer, children's illustrator. I'm also an entrepreneur. I'm the CEO of Pallets Furniture Kenya. I started this business back in 2020 during the COVID period. I started by making what we call the floating rope shelves. Then from there, my friends liked the shelves and they started commissioning for such works. That's how I started, and from that I made a tweet on Twitter which went viral. I love wood pallets because this is a form of art. You know, it allows me to use my creativity and the aspect of designing. Yes, so that's why I love wood pallets. From pallets, we make all sorts of furniture, from beds, seats, everything else. We also make, done interiors for clubs. We also do sets for theater, stage tech theaters.
So far, we have been able to see that the business is booming. Business is good. So far, so good. This is, however, not what happens all the time. As in any normal business, one experiences a few challenges here and there.
Business, as usual, has its ups and downs. There are times when there's business, there are times when there's no business. So it's never a straight line. Some of the challenges that come with this business is, there are times when we lack pallets because we have to wait for them from go downs so that we can pick them. So there are times we can even go for weeks without getting pallets. And that becomes a challenge because, let's say for instance, you've taken an order from a client and you promised them that you're going to clear their work in a span of 1 week. But here you are, you don't even have those pallets. So that is one of the main challenges. The other challenge is there are times when clients will not pay you after you've done their work. You know, you've done your work, you've even delivered, but now when it comes to paying, it becomes a bit problematic. Some of these challenges, I try to overcome them by trying to look for ways to go around some of these challenges. For example, if I know that there's a challenge of a client refusing to pay, so what I'll do is I'll make sure that upon delivery, you've cleared the remaining amount of money. I don't want to wait, you know, any much longer. My target customers are mostly the youth, because the youth are the one who love fashion. Let me say somehow trend things, and they're also the ones who are receptive to change, you know. the old people love using the old furniture, but now the youths would love to have something that is new, something that is something that someone else does not have.
I was able to talk to Michael Rading, who is among the many young people who decided to try out the wooden pallets and are still using the same pallets up to date.
So I have been using pallets for, say, 2 years when I was still in campus. I prefer them because they are affordable for comrades. They are easy to carry around if you want to move out, for example. With pallets, you can design them as you wish or as you prefer. So it's something I would recommend for people to use in their houses.
My target customers are most of my clients are mostly from online. That's where I get most of my clients, because I sell on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Yes. So that's where I basically get my clients. Some of the achievements that I've had from this business is one of the main is that from making sets, I was voted the best set designer for the year 2021. If there's one item that I made and I cannot forget, was there was this. It was a shelf which could transform into a table. So at one point it's a shelf, then it can transform into a table. It's one of the best pieces that we've ever made here.
Okay.
This business is time consuming in the sense that, you know, when you get pallets, they're very low. So there's a lot that goes into making them the finished products that you will see. So for that reason, I have several people who I work with to make sure that process, you know, does not take a lot of time. If someone is sanding, someone else is doing something else, so that we can, to make sure that the amount of time that is used, you can limit it. What motivates me and keeps me going is the fact that people love our work and they appreciate that. So we know whatever we are doing is good and people like it, so we have to keep doing it. So, I do so many things at the same time. So how I'm able to balance this is, one is not knowing your time, knowing how to plan your time very well. And the fact that I also have people who help me, that makes it easy for me. So if for example, I'm having a show, I'm supposed to go for rehearsals, so I'll come to the workshop in the morning, do whatever I'm supposed to do, then at some point I'll leave and go for rehearsals. So I just need to plan my day. That's the only way you can be able to juggle all these things, is just knowing how to plan your time and sticking. Yes, and the fact that they are all art related, let's say for example, I'm doing a show. In that show, I'm the set designer. So everything is all about art. So I find it very easy for me. You know, there's nothing that I don't have to make reports for someone else, or, you know, it's something that I'm passionate about. So I find it very easy.
It simply started with a tweet he posted back in 2020. Brian Irungu chose to use his talent as an opportunity to make a living, as he also enjoys doing it. He says that it is so much easier for him to do this because he found a niche that allows him to cut across so many areas. He is able to explore his expertise using wood art, and one of his major achievements is that he won the Best Set Designer Award at the Kenya Theatre Awards early this year. This talented actor, painter, books illustrator, set designer, and entrepreneur is able to effortlessly kill so many birds with one stone, because according to him, all his arts marry each other. His business has been booming both offline and online via his social media handles.
One word for those people who have not tried Food and Palettes.
So for anyone who's not tried Palettes, you're missing out. This is the future. This is the future of furniture. This, anything you can ever think about in terms of furniture, Palettes, we can do that.
Anyone who has experienced the Wooden Palettes furniture gets addicted to them. This is because they add a creative touch to their spaces. They're unique, they save space, they're affordable, and are of very much high quality. Wooden Palettes furniture are the new norm. You should definitely try.